And now, the worst streamer on the internet, Battery H.
Hey, good evening, everybody. It's day 72 of 100 days of gaming. Guess what that means? That's right. You can see it coming up now. More Planet Coaster. Thanks, everybody, for joining us. Hey, guess what? We reached $810 with a $50 donation from one of my coworkers today who asked not to be named. It's sad because they are a really awesome person. So that beautiful Planet Coaster music today is just for them. What this means is normally we'd be doing a giveaway tonight, but because we're doing Planet Coaster, and because I have no idea how long it's going to take me to do Planet Coaster tonight, we're going to do our giveaway tomorrow. That's right. Hey! So there I am. Gotta love that good-looking orange shirt. So we're going to do our giveaway sometime tomorrow, and tomorrow's streams we're going to come in two flavors. One will be our normal Saturday morning stream, which we're going to do Planet Coaster with instead of Fallout. Yep. So the first thing we're going to do in the morning actually is a makeup stream at 8:30, from 8:30 to 10:30. For Tuesday's stream, we'll be playing American Truck Sim. And then starting at about 11:30 Central Time and going to about 1:30-ish or so, we're going to do some more Planet Coaster. And that'll be our normal stream for day 73 of 100 Days of Gaming. And what's this 100 Days of Gaming you keep talking about, dude? It's our way of bringing forth information on Extra Life, which is a charity that raises money for the Children's Miracle Network Hospitals. It's 170 hospitals across North America, including Puerto Rico. That's right. And I'm standing down near one of them. And these hospitals, every dollar we raise goes to the sick and injured kids directly. No money for overhead or anything else. So if you'd like to make a donation to me, if you like my stream so much that you want to go beyond the normal follower subscribe, and you want to make a donation, if you're watching this on Twitch, just type !extralife, E-X-T-R-A-L-I-F-E, I can spell. Or if you're on YouTube, it's even more simple. Just go to the description. You'll find a link to my Extra Life page. I'm raising money for Children's Hospital of New Orleans, which is why I'm kind of standing in southern Louisiana, though it's hard to see. And my goal this year is $1,337. We're at $810 on November 5th in just 4 weeks, guys. I'm going to be doing a 25-hour marathon. That's right, 25 hours, and since it's probable that Planet Coaster will be in full beta by then, we're going to dedicate at least 2 hours to Planet Coaster. So if you know someone that's staying at one of the hospitals, please have them get on. I would love to take requests from the kids and things to do these stuff during that. So November 5th starts at 8:30 in the morning. If you go to my page, and I'll be listening here on Twitch as well, with details of what time I'm playing, what games and things like that, I'll probably be doing Planet Coaster sometime in the early afternoon. With that being said, let's get back. I ditched the park we did yesterday. Not because I think what we did was bad. I just wanted to go a new way, and I started to do a little bit of a layout of a couple of things. So we've got this. And this is kind of where we are. I'll pause it right now. I've kind of done a start of a layout here. And the start of this layout is going to have two sections. One is going to be very fantasy-oriented, at which you can see we've got a couple of knights here. Actually, it'll be kind of neat. Let's zoom way in here if we can. And we'll kind of get ourselves walking into the park a little bit here. So we're doing this from a kid's perspective. So as you walk in, you see there's King Coaster. We're going to work on some stuff around the little lake here. And then you'll see these two guys here. The guards that have started, and we're going to work with them a little bit. And then if you go the other way, I got a little more put up over here. You can see that this will kind of be our pirate-ish land, complete with a big pirate wheel. We've got a sentry standing tall here over the fruit basket. And you'll see I built a little shop here for Cosmic Cow Milkshakes. We have a beached boat nearby. Because I thought an arch with a boat over it, you know. I mean, what the heck, right? Everybody wants to have a carport for their boat. And you can come in here, buy your milkshakes, and then here and listen to them. Over by the pirate band. So we're going to put up some rides and do a few things with that and see if we can make this area kind of work. And we'll show off some of the terrain tools. And you'll note that when I did this little bit here, I did not apparently put the peaks back that I put. Yeah, it doesn't do that well. So here, let me get that other piece of building that I forgot to stick on there. Because that was a smooth move. Building, we'll go into... That's coaster stations. Actually, let's go and select this here, right? So this is all part of this building, and we need to edit the building a little more. So once we've gotten in here, we can get into shops and facilities. Sorry. That's not really what we want. I don't really want a building. Custom. I'm always looking in the wrong place, and the section we were in here is this lime plaster wall. The 2 meter ought to be what we need, and we're going to just kind of stick that in there and use our shift key to bring it up level, and then we can get rid of that, and there we're done with that. And it's got 20 objects put with it, so you see it's got the Cosmic Cow sign and the milkshakes and all that stuff. So, so there's a spot for this. I think in the meantime, what we need to do is get some path extras. We'll get the barrel benches over here, so we'll kind of... give a few places for folks to sit down with their shakes. And every so often, we'll just stick a little bin here. And it's kind of got that Spanish main Irish look. It's not really stucco, although they do have stucco. So let's put some more of the terrain in here. Actually, we're going to do the paintbrush. We're going to use the sand, and we're going to increase the size and intensity of the brush a little bit here. Stray outside and start working the sand around this section. Because we're going to put a ride in over here, I think. Our first ride at the park. Okay, so we've gotten that done. Let's take a look at some rides now. What do you think? It's time for a little Rocktopus, maybe? A little Rocktopus! We're gonna place the entrance kind of around back here, and we'll place an exit here. And the nice thing of it is that exit will connect directly. Add the queue to the entrance. So what we need to do is select our queue type. See, we can do an enable a priority pass. Well, I guess we can't do that. Disable priority pass. Customize. Let's see, what I'd like to be able to do here is I'm trying to figure out how to change this. Alright, we've opened up Rocktopus. But I don't think we're done yet. I think we need to do some scenery building here. We need to build some stuff around this queue, and I think what we need to do is do some building. Sandstone walls and arches and all kinds of wonderful things that they've got here. Thank you. Someone wants to line up in the wrong places. Let me see if I can do this again here. Well, that's not going as well as I had hoped. So there we have that. Let's see here. We'll have a gable, I think, on top. Okay, there's all of those things. Now we can get some roofs. Again, we've got the stands, the sandstone, which is kind of nice. We can do the red tiled roof again. Inner corner, tiled roof, blah, blah, blah. Gonna want something with a peach. So let's do this. We're starting to move these across. Kind of gives us a base building, I guess. So there we go. Not a lot of talk right now. Hey, let's boost things up so you can see a little better. I've got to remind me of these things. So we've got Rocktopus open. I can't tell if there's anybody actually coming in or not. Thank you. So we've got our first ride. I think another ride is in order over here, probably. A little more gentle. Because, you know, you can't really have a pirate theme place. Without having that giant pirate ship. Again, having our exit over there is kind of a good thing, I guess. It kind of gives us what we need. I think we're going to move the enemies back here. And they'll come in from the side and then work their way out straight. And we'll add our cube. Now, I wonder... Again, I'd really like to know how I can change this entrance, right? Getting a little bit of it. Guess we never did test this bad boy either, did we? Make it easy, won't it? and thank you very much for the host. We always love to hear our boosters engaging. Now, of course, that means we have people coming in. What is going on, I wonder? Park management says... can't train him till July 26th, so apparently you cannot train your folks right away. There's his happiness level. Okay, here comes some folks. I wish I could throw this away somewhere so we don't have enough bins. Okay, well, that's fixable. And I know that they're going to stand there and get entertained by him. Why aren't there enough bins? Are there plenty of bins around here now? Someone needs to build some benches. Well, we're going to work on that over here as well. So, more scenery over here, so more benches. Anything that resembles a queasy kind of ride, you're going to want to put some benches nearby. Okay, and then I think we want to put some other scenery, props, filter by group scenery theme. We want to go with the pirate stuff. So we're just going to look at that. Maybe put him over here. Possibly a pirate. Guarding back and firing back kind of animal. And we need to get some sand under that. So the terrain under there, sand, sin needs to be spread. And then maybe for scenery, we can do some foliage. And for this, instead of filtering by scenery theme, we're going to do it by nature region, tropical. And that'll give us some up and away. Yeah, that's starting to look a little better over there, I think. And as you can see, they're starting to see the theme devices that work their way around here. This park is where should I go on first, see? And you can start to see, you know, we can go to the group information, so we can go to Carrie and see what his recent thoughts are. He hasn't had any. We have a lot of thoughtless folks. Starting to get some. I'd better get to a bathroom soon. So that's the other thing we probably need to add around here. Okay. So let's pause. We've got a drink stand over here, so it stands to reason we should probably put a restroom nearby. And over here between these two rides, it's kind of got a little space here. I think we can do that. So let's go to shops. Go to the old restrooms. Now see, there is a blueprint here for a toilet shack. Which actually has two ends of the toilets. So you could put that here. Kind of work from two directions, I guess. Actually, I think the other option we have is kind of over here. And by doing this, if we turn the whole thing a little bit, kind of do that, and then we can path the sand path from here. Alright. The sandstone path there, and we've pathed into our toilets, our toilet shacks. And they are standard restroom block, guest thoughts. I don't know if it lets you charge for me or not, but can add a little more scenery. Well, first let's add maybe a bench or two over here. Some bins to throw anything that you happen to have away with you there, and that'll do that right nicely. It's a beech tree. Birch tree. Kind of like that sitting there. It's a little different. It kind of seems to almost offset, but it doesn't really. You got some spooky stuff. You got our pirate stuff. You got our pirate gibbets here. And add a few of these torches along the way here so that as it gets dark out we'll be able to have a little light. Okay. I see the bamboo torches are kind of there. The lanterns, the skull lampposts, the standing torches, the street lamps. So that's kind of that's pretty cool looking over there. And then we can do the same sort of thing for the squidlies over here, I think. And we can kind of give that a special look to it. And then if we go into our building mode, maybe doors and windows, roofs, decorations. We can get lighting in here. Dragon lamps, candle lamps. They're not really hanging at the same height, but does anyone really care? More importantly, it gives a little bit of light inside to the cube. I don't know why they're not lighting this one. Octopus one looks too gentle for me. Wow, okay. Apparently they don't understand the concept of gentle. Okay, I think the next thing we're going to do is maybe get a ride or two over here in the Fairy Kingdom. And then eventually we're going to add a roller coaster in there. So thrill rides, gentle rides, transport rides we don't have yet. Thrill rides. That's interesting. They put the maintenance shed over near the exit. Huh. So add queue to the entrance, and for this one, I think we want to go to the very happy bluey place. Give it that definite fairish festivalish. gonna test the entrance. Start the test. See, the smoke FX starts to work now. Electricity, miscellaneous stuff. So we got bubbles, lasers. So we get a few trees around there. A floral bush or two. We can start to see the beginnings of something take place. Now, over here, I have plans for something. I think we're going to start setting it up tonight, and maybe, just maybe, we'll be done with it by tomorrow. So we're going to sort by fairy tale. And what we are going to need... Oh, I thought he was much bigger. Okay, actually, the first thing I think we want to do is get the terrain adjusted. So... Okay, so we've got ourselves our sleeping dragon here. Let's try to get it to the point where we actually get daylight here during the day so we can actually see what we're doing here. Okay, he does breathe a little bit of smoke. Wow. Eventually, gonna kind of need to put the box light him in, I think, probably. Okay, this is gonna be a really cool final. This is gonna be the final twist around in the rope. The plan is to build a roller coaster and have you, and actually enclose this in a cave. And have you come darting in and then swooping up and around. And as you exit the cave, you're going to find a couple of more dragons set up in and around. And this is kind of like the final encounter thing, where that's what you're finished off with. So that's kind of where I want to end up with this one. And of course, what we'll end up doing is building a mountain above all of this. Which will be really, really interesting, I think, because we're going to have to spin the coaster up above it. Wow. This is going to be real interesting, I think. I'm hoping I can make this work. So, roller coasters. 4D Eurofighter family coaster kind of thing. Custom coasters. Steel coasters. We don't have wood coasters yet, obviously. So we're going to take a look at there's these Eurofighters. Abnormal banking past vertical drops and tight corners. Hyper coasters with 80 style strains. Hyper coasters, it's all about airtime and high vertical G forces. Dizzying heights and drops, that's the Giga Rage. inverted rivals, right? So you're kind of secured below the track with that one, which would be interesting from a standpoint of custom looping to specifically designed for inversions. Flying Stingray, head first prone position, giving them a sensation of flying along the track. A coaster to thrill both adults and children. We're beginning to sound a lot like Christmas, because this portion is designed to kind of work with the kids as well. So, oh, this is the way it goes. What if I wanted to go the other way? Push the train, slow the train down, push the train up and climb. Okay, so what I want is okay, let's see. Okay. Coasters. Custom. Children's coasters. To go back here, and I wish to delete. And what I wish to do is how did this all get turned bloody around? Okay. Thank you. Okay, obviously I'm going to need more work on figuring out how to build this. Because I cannot seem to get it to run the way I want it to run, which is the other way. And get it to run the way that I want it to do that, which is this one. So let's go here and delete these. Coasters custom. Junior Wendigos. Let's just do this for now. This is a very long train. Did you notice that? Don't want to do that. I mean, really, come on, almighty, for crying out loud. Okay. Well, that's starting to look a little bit like it could do something, I guess. As you can see, we are building new coasters and new things, and it does take some time. Let's get a slightly smaller train, I think. I'll make it all the way up, but that's kind of looking more like what I was expecting. Okay, I think we're starting to get somewheres with this thing. And as you can see, it's starting to... I think we're going to have enough motion. That's the big thing, right? Excitement. Nauseous down low. Oh, excitement's right in the band. Nauseous a little high there. Nope, not quite enough. All right. That's okay. Thank you. Let's take a look at this from the experience point here. Let's take a look from the writer's perspective here. So you can see our nauseous where we want it. No real fear, no real excitement. Excitement starts to build as you get up to the top. Kind of takes the, and I think we'll start that. Okay. We can start that rolling down the hill, and we've nearly come to a stop, and that's the nice thing about that is that by doing that we can turn ourselves into a diving turn. Continues. A little ways here. We put that piece, and then the next piece we actually move straight again. Take her back down to, there we go, look at that, and continuing to drop. Yep, nope, it's not gonna make that climb. Oh, what the heck? think we're going to have to pick this up tomorrow, folks. How did... Oh, boy. Somehow this keeps jumping sections of track. Okay. Oh, good Lord. No, 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 no. How did this operations get going? No. Well, it's certainly going to go flying off now, isn't it? At least we're there. Okay. We're going to go ahead and save this as Park 1, and we're going to call it an evening. Hey, thanks everybody for watching. I appreciate y'all stopping out. Special thanks to Janet over at the Secret World in Otterdown for hosting me tonight. Thank you very, very much. Hey, this has been Day 72 of 100 Days of Gaming, as we're supporting Extra Life. That's right, the charity that works to heal sick and injured kids. Thank you all very much. We're at $810, guys. We're getting close. The end is almost in sight. Our goal is $1,337. We're less than $500. We're a little more than $500 away. Guys, with your help, we can make it this year. It's going to be so awesome if we do that. I will. We do it before game day, and I lose the hair. I didn't think I had to worry about that. With that being said, everybody, have a wonderful night. I will see you all tomorrow morning at 8:30 a.m. with some American Truck Simulator, and then again at 11:30 a.m. Central Time with more Roller Coaster Tycoon. Until then, everybody, make sure your track is finished, because trains that go shooting off into the crowd lead to death and dismay. Have a good night, everyone.
You've enjoyed the stream, despite the awful host. Please consider a donation to Extra Life. Thank you for watching.